Hello students, good morning. Today it's our lecture number 9, and you know we are in lesson number 15. So again I heartily welcomes you in our digital online class, and in this lesson we studying here cube and cuboid. Initial means half part of this lesson is area and then volume. So you can see here exercise 15.1, we already solved few sums in previous lecture number 8. So they are related to area only. So now let's see remaining sums, and before seeing remaining sums, let's revise all the formula that are required here. So you can look here, CSA of cuboid. CSA means curved surface area. Actually it should be here LSA, lateral surface area. You just understand LS and CSA are sometimes synonyms. So LSA of cuboid 2H L plus B. TSA of cuboid 2LB plus BH plus LS. We already understood where from and how it is so. Okay. But now I am not going in so deep where from it came. Now surface area of cuboid open at one end. So that is different than LSA or TSA. Why? Because there is a four surrounding surface and one bottom or roof, anyone should also be considered. So here you can see this is LSA only. Okay. Whatever initially given, that is nothing but a LSA. Okay, you can see here. But something is added there, and that is LB. Why LB? Because all surrounding surface we have taken, and this is somewhat extra. So LB is added there. So CSA plus something, but actually it is not TSA. Understood? We already used this formula. Now same way, it is very simple. In LSA of cube, there are four surfaces surrounding, only four walls, so 4L square, and each surface is square, so L square is there. In TSA 6L square, but TSA, not TSA, but surface area of cube open at one end 5L square. So why 5? Because one surface is not we counting here. Now CSA of cube or cuboid, it is applicable to both ones, cube and cuboid. You can find that way also, perimeter of base into height. So if you say here perimeter means you are given perimeter of base and height is given, then also you can find CSA means curved surface area, or here lateral surface area of cube or cuboid. Understood? So this is the, in one sense you can say new also, otherwise it is repeating also. Because why? 2 into L plus B is a perimeter into H. So in that sense it is not new, but if you try to remember it separately, then obviously you can it. So perimeter into height is equal to also lateral surface area. Now it is the relation, 1 meter square is equal to how many centimeter square? Obviously 10 raised to 4 will be here, not 2, because 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter, so it will be 10 raised to 4 means 10,000, and 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 meter square. If you know, mostly land is measured in hectare. Land is measured in hectare. Okay, farmer saving how much land? So many hectares. So this is bigger unit, 10,000 meter square collectively from 1 hectare. So remember that one also. And here I make correction here, 10 raised to 4 centimeter square. So understand all this formula and remember them. Okay, somewhere it may be applicable, and we applied most of them also so far. So now let's start our practice. Okay. Look there, swimming pool is 20 meter in length, 15 meter in breadth and 4 meter in depth. Find the cost of cementing its floor and walls at the rate of this. What is the rate? Rupees 12 per square meter. So now where to cement there? Means cementing is required where? At 4 walls and at the any one either floor or bottom. Okay, so here they told floor. So obviously it is this formula. Just look, it will be this one only. Why? Because 5 sides are there, 5 surfaces are not all 6. Okay, so we will use this formula here and just putting all values we can find it. Okay, so find required area. So area of cuboid, I'm not here clearing that it is LSA or TSA. It is not LSA, not TSA, in between somewhere there. So it will be 2H L plus B plus LB means floor. So floor surface area is length into breadth. So now put all values. Height is given here 4. Length is given 20. Breadth is 15 plus 20 into 15, L into B. So it will be 8 into 35 plus 300. Okay, 35 is as so 5 is a 44. 8 is a 24 plus 4, 28. Okay, now just add them. So it will be 3580. Okay, here is meter everywhere, so meter square. But now they are asking us cost of cementing. So write down cost of cementing is equal to 580 into 12. Why? Because per meter square it is 12 rupees. So many meter square we are having. So how much total cost will be there? So count it and multiply 58, 12, 580, 16, 1, 11. So 6, 9, 6. So it will be rupees 6960. Okay. So that is our final answer. So try to understand here. It is our question number 8. And it finally, how we found cost, just try to understand. And if you want, you can note down also, otherwise take screenshot also. Okay, so answer is 6960 rupees. So first of all, select appropriate formula. How we decided it? Because look here, cementing its floor and walls. Walls means lateral surface area, this part only. But floor we have to add here. So accordingly, select formula, write all value and then multiply by rate. So you will have cost. Okay, so it's very simple, just understand question that's required here. Okay, now it is quite longer one. Just try to read whatever given here. A lovely sweet house was placing an order making cardboard boxes for packing their sweets. Okay, lovely sweet house is the name of that shop. Okay, so placing an order for making cardboard boxes for packing their sweets. So they want to prepare boxes, cardboard boxes. Two size of boxes are required. The bigger box of dimension 30 by 20 by 5 means length, breadth, height given, and the smaller box of dimension 15 by 12 by 5 given. For all the overlaps, 5% of the total surface area is required extra. So first of all, count only area of boxes. Two types of boxes we are having. If the cost of the cardboard is rupees 5 for 1000 centimeter square, find the cost of the cardboard required for supplying 500 boxes of each kind. So we have not having one box, 500 small box, 500 big box. So let's find first of all area of all. So here we have to find total surface area because box will not be open, obviously closed. Okay. So now let's find one by one area. So now consider bigger box only. So how much area of 500 bigger boxes? So directly you can find area of 500 bigger box also. Okay. So first of all, find surface area of or total surface area of 500 bigger boxes. Okay, we should be clear here. So let they are L2LB plus BH plus LH. Measurements are there. And this is the way of giving measurements. It is not multiplication. 30 by 20 by 5. So it's not necessarily multiplication is there. This is the way of giving measurement. So now L into B means L is 30, B is 20. Then B is 20, H is 5. Then L is 30, H is 5. So it will be 600, 100, and 150. So 600 plus 1700 plus 150, 850. So it will be 8 to the 16 plus 1700 centimeter square. So these are area of all 500 bigger boxes. Now smaller boxes having the same way, different dimension, they are in same numbers. So again, find surface area of 500 smaller boxes. So surface area of 500 smaller boxes. Sorry, at last we have to note 501 surface area of each bigger box. Okay. Because we have not multiply here by 500, that's why. Now again, surface area of each smaller box equal to how much? Again, same formula, 2LB plus BH plus LH. So it will be 2. Now dimensions are here. 15, 12, 5. So 15 into 12 plus 12 into 5 plus 15 into 5. So it will be 180 plus 60 plus 75. Okay. Now make total of them. So 2. It will be 0 plus 5. 5. Now 8 plus 6, 14. 14 plus 7, 21. 2 plus 1, 3. Again verify them. 5 only. Then here 7 plus 6, 13. 13 plus 8, 21. 2 plus 1, 3. Okay. So it will be 630 centimeter square. But they are of 1 each. Now we required total 500. Okay. So now total area. So total area of 500 boxes of each type. Okay, so multiply by here 500 to this one and plus 500 to 630. Okay, understand well. This is the one bigger box, but we are having so many. Here one smaller box, but having so many boxes are there. So now count them. So 17 5s are 85. Total 40 will be there. Same way, here first of all write 30, 5 3s are 15, 1, 5 6 are 30, 31. Okay, now make total of them. So it will be our final area. So first of all, 30 are there, 5 is here, 5 plus 1 6, and 8 plus 3 11. Again, 30 and 5. So that must gone. Now 85 plus 31. So 5 plus 1 6, 8 plus 3 11 centimeter square. Okay. Now what is the rate they have given? Rupees 5 per 1000 centimeter square. So actually we are having so many centimeter square. So now you can do cross multiplication step. Otherwise you can write directly also to multiply by rate, but it is not per 1 centimeter square rupees 5. So 1 centimeter square's rate will be 5 upon 1000. Okay, so I can find your cost of packing equal to how much? 1165000 into 5 upon 1000. Why 5 upon 1000? Because per centimeter square it is so much only. So zeros cancel out, whatever left, 5 5s are 25, 2 6 5s are 30 plus 2 32, 3 5 1s are 5 plus 3 8 and 5. So many rupees means 5825. But 5% extra is needed. Sorry, we have not right now multiply it because they told us to 5% extra is also there. So basically not consider this. This is not our total area. Still 5% extra we have to add. This is for finishing purpose. Okay, extra. So now not cost of this much area only, somewhat area will be more. Okay. Now try to find 5% of it, then add that one. So actually total area we will have. So now area including that word. So how much area it is? 1165000 and 5% extra. So totally 105% will be there. Otherwise just find 5%. So 5% of 1165000 centimeter square is equal to how much? 5 upon 100 into 1165000. Okay, 5% of given numbers. So 20 cancel out. 10 is there. Now multiply by 5. 5 5s are 25. 2 6 5s are 30 plus 2 32. 3 5 1s are 5 plus 3 8 and 5. Again verify it. 10 placed. 5 5s are 25. 5 6s are 30 plus 2 32. 3 5 1s are 5 plus 3 8 and 5 1s are 5. So this centimeter square extra. So now you have to add area this and that. Okay. So it will be how much? So now total area will be, now I writing here only. Therefore total area extra as well as this equal to how much? 1165000 plus 58250 is equal to, okay, so add here only 1165000 plus 250 58, so it will be 0 5 2 8 plus 5 13 1 6 plus 6 12 12, so finally it will be 1 2 2 3 2 5 0 centimeter square. Now you have to multiply this one by its rate, okay, then you will have only answer. Okay, again they have given rupees 5 per 1000 centimeter square, okay, so we have to first of all divide it by 1000, so per centimeter square cost will be how much? 5 upon 1000, otherwise cross multiply 1000 centimeter square 5 rupees, so many centimeter square how many rupees, so that way you can do cross multiplication step also, otherwise find rate of 1 centimeter square, obviously it will be 5 upon 1000, okay, so I am not doing right now calculation, okay, but after all cost will be what, so cost will be this one 1 2 2 3 2 5 0 into 5 upon 1000, so now you can count it so that it will be your answer, okay, so understand whatever I have written final answer you have to try, just one step is left there, just multiply it, okay, and find out cost, so understand whole question here and try to find cost. Okay, and here 1000 is there. Okay, per 1000 it is so. So 5 upon 1000. So answer that is given and it is right 6116.25. So I am not showing here calculation, but 6116.25. Okay, you just verify it. 6116.25 rupees will be there. So that will be our final answer. So again, I explaining it fast. First of all, understand question well. It is quite long. You just say in your textbook it is given. Okay, so just try to understand it. And there are two types of boxes, smaller, bigger, and each of 500 in numbers. So we found first of all one bigger box area, same way one smaller box area, but not one. We are having 500, total 1000 boxes are there. So we found total area of bigger boxes 500 and smaller boxes 500. So multiply by 500. So much total area we got here, but still they want 5% of the total surface area required extra for overlapping purpose. Some board, paper or cardboard will be overlapped. So we count here 5% of this total also there. Then we added this number and that number. Both numbers are added. So this is the required, this is the extra, and then total we got 1 2 2 3 2 5 0 centimeter square. This is our final area. Now for finding cost, what is the rate? Rate means per one. So per 1 centimeter is 5 upon 1000. So if you try, just you will have answer this much. Okay, so understand the question well and then the solution. And you can take screenshot also now. Okay, now question number 10. What is given? The floor of a rectangular hall has a perimeter 250 meter. Perimeter given. Its height is 6 meter. Find the cost of painting its four walls at the rate of rupees 6 per square meter. So it is very simple. Today only I have given you one formula of getting its lateral surface area. Lateral surface area means four walls surrounding, four walls only. Okay, so just perimeter into height you can do. After getting perimeter into height, you will have lateral surface area means area of four walls. Then just multiply by 6. Okay, so it will be very simple. LSA means lateral surface area of whatever is there, wall. LSA of rectangular hall. So it is shape also there, and what is the thing that is also given. So it will be P means perimeter of base into height. Perimeter into height means perimeter what? Of base. So obviously both are given. Then just multiply by 6. So in homework. So number 10 is in homework, understand. Based on which formula, I just showing you that formula only here. Otherwise I have given, so I think no need to go there. It is applicable in cuboid as well as cube and in cylinder also, because they are prism. What is meant by prism? Prism means whatever bottom, same shape is at top also, then it is called prism. So prism are three. We are now studying three prism. Cube, cuboid and cylinder. They all three are prism. So everywhere this is applicable. LSA of rectangular hole or CSA of cylinder, whatever may be, perimeter into height. In another formula also we will study volume. So volume equal to area of base into height. Here perimeter into height, there will be area into height. So we will have volume also. So understand this extra two formula based on perimeter of base and area of base. So respectively you will have LSA and volume. Okay, same formula I am giving you also, but not for this sum. Another formula, volume. So volume equal to area into height. Volume equal to area into height. In next exercise it will be used again. So A for what? Area of base. Just like P for what? Perimeter of base. Okay, so if base information is there and height is there, it is enough to find either LSA or volume. So understand both formula here that way. Whenever it is applicable in prism. Which prism we are studying right now? Cube, cuboid, cylinder. Why? Because they are equal at top and bottom, that's why. There are so many types of prism. Triangular prism may be there. In science you learn, in physics, for scattering of light, that prism is actually triangular prism. So prism is common word. Prism is not specific. It is common. Actually you use prism word basically at triangular prism. Okay? Otherwise only prism is meaningless there. Understood? So this is in homework. Okay, now look next. The dimension of a room are 8 by 7.5 by 5. It is one door of dimension 2 by 1.5 and two windows of each of dimension 2 by 1. Find the cost of whitewashing the walls at rupees 20 per square meter. We want to whitewash at wall only, not one door. Obviously, it is matter of common sense only. So, we have to find first of all area of four walls, then subtract area of wall as well as window. Sorry, area of door as well as window. That should be subtracted. So first of all, surface area of four walls. Equal to 2h L plus B. this is height. L plus D means 8 plus 7.5. Okay, I placed all values. Now we are about walls only, not window, not door. This is only. Okay, so L is 5, L 8.5 and B is 7.5. So it will be 10, 5 2s are 10 and this will be 15.5. So 155 meter square. So this is the total area of wall, but inside wall there will be door, windows like that. So we have to subtract first of all that and then only we will do whitewash. Means cost is found by remaining, means finding area of purely walls only. Now find area of door. We are having one door only. One door. What measurement? 2 by 1.5. Area of one door. Door or windows are rectangular. Doors or windows are rectangular. Okay. So here L into B. But here not that L and B. Here are 2 and 1.5. So 2 into 1.5. So it will be 3 meter square. Same way, area of two windows. So now every time formula is not needed, you can write directly also. Okay. So it will equal to 2 into L into B. But here L and B are different. 2 into 1. Why 2? Because two windows are there. That's why. So 2 into 2 into 1. So it will be 4 meter square. Okay. Now we should subtract this both area from wall. So now area for whitewashing. Area for whitewashing. It will be 155 minus 3 plus 4. Means collectively we will subtract it. So 155 minus 7. 148 meter square. Okay. Now they are giving us the rate rupees 20 per square meter. Okay. So now cost is equal to whatever area 148 into this is the rate 20. So it will be 0, 8 to the 16 and 14 into 2, 28 plus 9. So it is, sorry. Okay, so now 148 into 20 rupees is there. Okay, so 8 to the 16 and 29, this much rupees. So 2960 rupees will be cost of whitewashing four walls. We found first of all lateral surface area, because four walls is nothing but a lateral surface area. But one door and two windows are there, so we found their area and then it is removed, means subtracted. So how much we got? 148. So this is the required area. Now area is multiplied by 20, by rate is given. So it is our final answer. So it is very simple. Just understand here question well and then solution. Okay, now look here. Surface area of cuboid given, length and breadth given, find height. So it is very simple. Surface area means total surface area. if only surface area is written, you understand all, total surface area. So obviously, if any one thing is missing, you can find. So TSA of cuboid equal to, what is there, 2 LB plus BH plus LS. So how much it is? 772 here. Okay. L and B are given, 14 into 11 plus B is 11, height not given, so H it is. L is given, 14, H not given. So it will be 772 divided by 2. I just shifting it here only. So equal to 14 into 11, 140 plus 14, 154 plus 11 H plus 14 H. Okay, look here, it is 2, 3 is 6, 2, 8 is 16, 2, 6 is 12. Now it is 154 plus, it is 25 H. Now subtract it. So 3, 8, 6 minus 154 equal to 25 H. Okay, 6 minus 4, 2. Okay, 8 minus 5, 3. 6 minus 4, 2, 8 minus 5, 3, and 3 minus 1, 2. So 2, 3, 2 upon 25 is equal to H. Okay, now you just divide it so that you will have value. So for, I don't want to divide it, I can here multiply also. 2, 3, 2, 25 into 4 into 4, so that I can get here hundreds. And here 4 to the 8, 4 3 are 12, and 4 to the 8 plus 1, 9. So it will be 9.28. Okay, 9.28 height. And unit is here centimeter, centimeter. So here also centimeter. Okay, so I think here nothing to understand, just simplify. Formula is, we selected TSA. Why TSA? If nothing is clear, then understand total surface. Now everything is there except height. So obviously from one equation, you can find one unknown. So it is just simplification method, nothing else. It's very simple. Okay, it's 13. The paint in a certain container is sufficient to paint an area equal to 17.25 meter square. So one container can paint this much area. How many box of dimension 45 into 10 into 7.5 centimeter can be painted out of this container? So obviously we have to find first of all area of one box. And then we can say how many boxes can be painted. So let's find first of all area of one box. Again, area means which area? Total, TSA. Okay. One box, how much? 2 LB plus BH plus LH. Okay, so it will be 2, 45 into 10 plus 10 into 7.5 plus 45 into 7.5. So twice, 45 tens are 450, it is 750, sorry, 75 only, because 7.5 into 10. Okay, then go ahead. So 75 only. Now 7.5 into 45. So let's multiply it. 7545. So it will be first of all 4 5 are 22 300 only 3000. Now 5 5 are 25, 2 7 5 are 35 plus 237. So 5733. But one decimal place is there, so it will be 337.5. Okay. Now just add all of them, so it is 450 plus 75 plus 337.5. So 0.5, 7 plus 5, 12, 1, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 7, 13 plus 3, 16, 1, 8. So it is 862.5. Now make it double. Okay. So just add same thing. So it will be 5, 12 and 17. 1725. Okay. Centimeter square. Now understand, one container paint, how much area? It is given in meter square. And you know, we just discussed in today's lecture only. 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square. So you have to convert that meter square into centimeter square, because here is centimeter square. Okay. So if you multiply by 10,000, then you will have centimeters. So now write down container can paint the area equal to how much? 17.25 into 10,000. So actually point will shift by 4 plus there, so it will be 172500 centimeter square. Now we can compare it. How? 1725 centimeter square, one box. For so many centimeter square, how many? Just to divide. Okay. So I can write directly number of boxes. Number of boxes. They ask how many boxes can be painted. So is equal to 172500 upon 1725. So it will be 100 only, obviously. So 100 boxes can be painted. Okay, understand well. Now, read next one. Okay, you can read from your book also. Okay, and try to understand it. Okay, so there is a cubical box, you can see there, and has is 25 centimeter, and another cuboidal box is 22.5 centimeter by 10 by 8. Okay, so two different shapes we are having. So they are asking which box has greater lateral surface area and which box has the greater total surface area. Understood? So cube having one measurement 20 and cuboid having three measurement, you know, LBH. Okay. So now we have to first of all find both ones lateral surface area as well as total surface area. So just write here what is given. So that is 20. So 4 cube, 4 cube L equal to 20 centimeter. Okay, 4 cube you can see here, and in your textbook also it is 20. So obviously its total surface area and lateral surface area will be how much? So let's divide our work into two parts. So now first of all they are talking about lateral surface area. Okay, so say LSA of cube is equal to 4L square. So is equal to 4 into 20 square. So it will be 4 into 400, 1600 centimeter square. Okay, now TSA. So TSA of cube, it will be 6L square, because in B they are asking this one only. This is second one of B, because here total surface area is being compared. So it will be 6 into 20 square means 6 into 400 is 2400 centimeter square. Okay, same way find area of cuboid also. So now 4 cuboid, okay, each measurement is given how, just understand. So they have given 22, 10 and 8. So L equal to 22.5 centimeter, B equal to 10 centimeter and H equal to 8 centimeter. Now again you can find LSA. So LSA of cuboid equal to 2H L plus B. So it is 2 into 8, 22.5 plus 10. So it is 16, and here 32.5. Okay, now 32.5 into 16, so it will be 325 into 16, so 3250, 65 is 33, 62 is 12 plus 3, 15, 16 is 18, 19, again 30, 12 plus 3, 15, 18, 19, okay, 0, 10, 12, 3, 4, 5, so it will be 5200 centimeter. So here centimeter square. So this is our first one. Now you can compare this one and this one. Okay, same way total surface area means TSA, total surface area of cuboid, how much? So 2HL plus B, sorry, 2 LB, BH, LH. Okay, now TSS formula I am going to write here. So it is 2 LB plus BH plus LH. So 2. Now LBH we already have 22.5. into 10 plus 10 into 8 plus 22.5 into 8 again. Okay, so it will be here 2, 225 here plus 80 is there, plus first of all 85 is a 40, it will go. Okay, 225 into 8. 85 is a 40, 4, 8 to the 16 plus 4, 20, 8 to the 16 plus 2, 18. So it will be 180. Now make total of all of them. So it will be 5, then 8 plus 8 is 16 plus 2, 18, 1, 3, 4. Again verify it. 5 plus 0 plus 0, 5. Then 2 plus 8, 10 plus 8, 18. 1 plus 2, 3 plus 1, 4. Now make it double. So 5 to the 10, 8 to the 16 plus 1, 17, 4 to the 8, 9. So 970 centimeter square. Now compare, LSA is bigger here, LSA is bigger here and TS is bigger here. Now actually it is 520, not 5200. Okay, just understand 520 into 0. Okay, so understand well it is. Otherwise I remove that 0 so you can not confuse there. Only that. Okay, now compare 1600 with 520 and 2400 with 970. So anyhow, cube having bigger area. Okay, which box has the greater lateral surface area? So again, cubical and which total surface area. So again that. And by how much you can found it by taking difference. Okay, let's count this one again. LB, BH, LS, that's okay. 22, 5, 10, 10, 8, and 22, 5, and 8. So it is 2 to 5. Here is 10, 8 is 80. And here 2 to 5 into 8. It is done here. It has a 40, 4, 16. Okay. So it is 180 only because point will be there. Now just add all of them. So 2 to 5 added. To 80, then 180. Okay, so it will be 5, 10 plus 8, 18, 1, 4, 4, 8, 5 into 2. So it will be 917. Here is 2400. So now what to do? Just compare them. The greater lateral surface area is where? So cubical. How much? You just subtract 1600 and 520. 1600 and 520. So you can say LSA is like is answer cubical box having more area. Cubical means this has more area. How much? So you can subtract it here 1600 minus 520. Okay, so equal to what? 80. And 15 minus 5, 10 centimeter square. Okay, same way you can find here also again cubical having. So again cubical box has more, this area is what? LSA. Okay, so clear there, area means which area? LSA only. And here TSA. How much? So again count 2400 minus 970. So it will be first of all 30 and 23 minus 9. So 1430 centimeter square. Okay. And now look their answer. They told here. In second one, they ask which box has the greater total surface area. Sorry, it is smaller as, that's why I'm confusing here. Actually, it is right in book smaller. So which one having smaller? Cuboidal. Now they are asking quite opposite way. So they are asking which box has smaller total surface area. So obviously, cuboidal box have total smaller surface area. So I have to correct here. Because according to their question, actually it is type here wrong. Actually, answer is right here. But according to question, I have to change here ki that having less area. Okay, so I just removing this part. That is right. Difference is okay. Okay, so just removing this part. According to their expectation of answer only. Okay, Now I can say about less only. So I can say cuboidal box has less TSA, total surface area, how much? 1430, and there is 10. Okay, so in first one, which having more, now asking which one having less. So accordingly you should give answer. Okay, now whole solution, you can say it is very simple, just comparison of different two types of shape is given, and both LSA as well as TSA are being compared here. Okay, so now you can understand whole question, and if you want, you can take screenshot also. Okay, now look at next last one. This is the 15th one. What is given? Length and breadth of a room given. In the ratio 3:2, height is given 4. Cost of papering 4 walls of a room, 8 rupees 1.20 per square meter is 162.50. Find the length and breadth of the room. Actually, here they have given us cost as well as rate. So what is means by cost and rate? So rate means per one and cost means per all. Rate means per one, cost means per all. So understand here, this is the per one only, per square meter means for cost of one only, and this is total. So obviously by cross multiplication step or by any way, you can find first of all area, because how? 1.25 rupees, 1 square meter area, 162.50 rupees, how much area? So obviously it will be division, and division of what? So look there, they are doing that work at 4 walls only, so it will be LSA. So you can say LSA of room, LSA of, actually which type of room they have told us, length breadth having different ratio, so obviously cuboid. So LSA of cuboidal room, so shape is also there, and what is there, that is also written, cuboidal room is equal to how much? 162.50 upon 1.25. now remove both places, 162.50 upon 1.25. Okay, so how much area is there, we can find here. So obviously it will be, first of all, ones are only 16250, so 125, ones are 125, how much left? 12 minus 5, 7, 5 minus 2, 3, now 5, so it will be 3, 3, 7, 5, 10 left there, so 130 meter square. Okay, so we got area for all. Actually it is indirectly given, area for walls is given indirectly, you can understand here, 135. How? Otherwise just use cross multiplication step, 1.25, 1 square meter area, 162.50, how many square meter area? So we got it. Now you know its formula. So LSA of cuboid equal to 2h L plus B. Now L and B are not given, but their ratio is given. So we can suppose it 3x and 2x. You know, whenever ratio is given, we just apply some letter there, which is actually HCF of both numbers. So now it is, we found 132. Height is given here 4. Now let's here 3x and breadth 2x. We can write here, let L equal to 3x and B equal to 2x. So we supposed it. Okay. So it will be 130 equal to 8 and here 3 plus 2 5x. So it will be 130 is equal to 40x. Okay, we want here length and breadth both. So 130 upon 40 equal to x. Gone. Okay, now 4. So it will be 4 threes are 12. 3.25 will be x. So we got here that one. 3.25. As soon as we get 3.25, we can place here a value of x. So we'll have length and breadth also. So now find here length equal to 3x, but not actually x, we got is 3.25. So it will be 9.75 what is given meter. In breadth 2x, but x is 3.25. So it will be 6.50 meter. Okay. So this is our final answer. So now understand this step well. Whenever they give us cost and rate both, at that time obviously we can have area. After getting area, we just place it here, and whatever missing here, actually both length and breadth ratio is given. So we suppose accordingly found x. After getting x, we just find it in supposition. So length and breadth both we found here. Okay. So understand. Okay, now let's talk about homework. I have given you one sum already. I think it is number 10. Okay, number 10 was given. Now come directly at miscellaneous exercise. I am giving you page number also. It 797. 797. So I writing here question for today's homework. So understand, first of all, question 10 from 14.2. Okay, this is the one. Now, from miscellaneous exercise, I giving few more. Okay, first and second, question 1 and 2 from miscellaneous exercise. Okay, so understand it well. This is today's homework. But in second one, they ask volume also. So we not to find here volume, because volume still we not discuss here, just diagonal. Okay, so total three sums are in homework, but understand, in second sum, no need to find volume. Okay, so I hope you enjoy and understood everything whatever we discussed today here. And from next lecture, we will start next topic and next exercise, and it will be regarding volume of cuboid. And you understood and remember its formula also. It is very simple. Volume of cuboid will be LBH, and volume of cube is L cube. Okay. So we will use that one and start volume in our next lecture number 10. Okay, students. Thank you very much.